Hello. How easy do you find it to ask for help? I don't know about you, but I actually find it easier to offer help than actually ask for it. And there have been moments in my own life where I've really struggled, but instead of reaching out, I've tended to withdraw into my cave and go really quiet and lick my wounds and just basically be by myself and suffer in silence. And I was curious about how other people are with that and what is the reason we struggle with it. And I've kind of looked at a few reasons that I think that people may struggle with asking for help. And the reason I wanted to look at this as a topic this week for my blog is I had a conversation, Anya Jeffries, who is the most inspirational woman. She's a fantastic mentor. She is somebody that has oodles of passion. I don't think the word "no, you can't do it" is in her awareness at all. And she usually does a week's work before breakfast. So she really puts me to shame with her workload. And she was being interviewed by me this week. I wanted to kind of get a sense of what she was about. She has an extraordinary story, by the way. And I asked her, what is your top tip that you believe really is the difference that makes the difference when it comes to accelerating your success in life? And she said, always ask for help. And I thought that was a kind of unusual and cool suggestion. So that's why I've blogged about it this week. The other topic that I've looked at is why I believe you can't teach charisma. And the reason I've done it is because my whole team have been kind of contacting me saying, oh, Nikki, did you know that so-and-so is doing workshops on charisma now? And is this company are doing it, that company are doing it. And how do you feel about that? And I think it's good. I think it's great that there is a growing awareness of charisma and the impact that a leader can have when he is working with more of his own innate charisma. And we're looking at, if you like, I suppose it's my competition. I never kind of see it as that because I think everybody has their own unique viewpoint to something. Yet everybody seems to be advocating a very different approach, using an approach based on tools, techniques, processes, behaviours. And I don't think you can actually teach charisma in that way. In fact, I don't think you can teach it. And the reason I think you can't teach it in that way is that if you're using a technique, a process, a behavior that is perceived as charismatic, and if that behavior is out of alignment with the essence of who you really are inside, I think you're going to come across as fake. And for me, the authenticity of how you are in that moment means that you express your charisma in your own unique way. And I believe that we are born with an abundance of charisma. And actually, it is just the obstacles and the problems, the challenges of life that actually create walls that are supposed to protect us, but actually block us from being able to tap in and reconnect with what is innate within us. So I have a different approach, and I think that's healthy for the market. And just wanted to explore that this week. Wherever you are, whatever you're doing, if it's raining, smile. It's not the end of the world. It's probably going to kind of brighten up a little bit tomorrow. And I guess if you're reading this or watching this from the States or wherever you are, then enjoy your day and we will reconnect again soon. Bye.